I want to focus primarily on the first subject, self-service password reset. I still don't understand why Microsoft didn't put this in Active Directory. Do you believe that your users are very proficient at this already? How many of your users have Facebook? How many of your users have an Amazon account? Do you think they remember those passwords? No. Can you even call Amazon to reset your password? No. So what do? Self-service password reset. I mean, normally when I teach a new technology, I'm like, I'm sorry, but you got to teach your users. You don't have to. They're going to immediately know what to do because they do it all the time. They forget their Amazon password just as much as they forget your corporate network password. So how do we do this? Well, inside of ADSelfService Plus, there is something called policies. How many other policies do you have in your world? 10, 20 of them, right? It's a word that's used a lot. Okay, we have group policy, we have security policy, we have this policy, that policy. Now you have ADSelfService policies. And ADSelfService policies define what you are going to give the end user. So we are going to go in and we are going to define as the administrator what we want our users to be able to do through a self-service portal. The options that are available: reset their password, unlock their account, self-update user account attributes that you think they should be able to update, and change their password. The first two do not require the user to know their existing password. So the first two are going to have additional security on top of them, because we don't want anyone just to be able to go in and reset passwords without some type of proof of who they are. We're going to need security on top of those, and we're going to have to define who receives what policy. I want maybe the IT help desk developers to be able to do all these things, but executives, maybe just reset their password. I mean, maybe we don't want them to have everything, okay? But you get to define that via OU or group. So at the foundation, we have policies. The policies define the three areas: what you're going to give through the portal, who you're going to give those to, and the security around how you're going to allow them to do it. Now, if we jump in, take a look at this. Here is my ADSelfService Plus, and here are my policy configurations. You see I have multiple policies. If I just pick one that I know is the biggest, it has all four, right? And then some of the other policies that I have may have all four, but I am limiting them to only certain, I think I did this one to groups, and then maybe an OU. What did I do this one to? This one is to an OU. There it is, okay? We also, per policy, need to define multi-factor authentication. Questions and answers is not a great way to do this. We have questions and answers, and we also have a Q&A strengthener so that you get to define as the administrator what you don't want your users to be able to put in for easy answers to questions, okay? Probably where we want to move to is what users have to do online, which is some kind of verification code, SMS, email, all right? Your users know how to do this. We also use Google Authenticator. So we're giving you options based on the way that you want to function and you want your users to function. Because these are related to password reset and unlocking of the account. And we want to make sure that users have verified themselves, can verify themselves on who they are, so we don't get the attackers getting in and resetting things and then getting access. We've also added an additional layer of security. Now, I wanted to throw this in because this is brand new, hot off the press. If you have ADSelfService Plus, you may not even know this exists. When a user has to reset their password or unlock the account, usually they do it through the Gina update. They click on the Gina update and boom, a web browser pops up that they can go in and reset. That's where you use this security. This is for password reset and unlock. If I am going to allow the user, after they've logged into their machine, to go into the portal, to gain access to the portal, we now have additional multi-factor authentication. Brand new, absolutely brand new, okay? This would be if they want to do a self-update or change their password. So we're allowing RSA, verification code, obviously SMS and email, and Duo security. First question I asked, when are we going to merge them? Very soon. It's on the roadmap. So this will overlap at some point. We will have these options in both. But for now, they're a little bit separate, okay? But at least we have them for security.